Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. You know how we do. Another month, another Book of the Month box unboxing. So this is March's Book of the Month box, and I didn't splurge as much as I usually do. For those of you that are unfamiliar with Book of the Month or haven't seen any of my previous videos, I will link them down below in the description box. But basically, this is a book subscription monthly service. They charge you, I think it's $15.95 or $14.95 a month. It gives you one credit. You get to pick your book of the month out of several selections. And then you can add two extra books to your box for just $9.99 per book. And they're all hardcovers and it's great. It's wonderful. I'm going to link the site in the description box and it'll be my personal affiliate type link. So if you want to check it out or join, I would appreciate it if you used my link. Once again, all that information in the description box. Let's move forward to the unboxing. So this month I only got two books and they are right here. Handy dandy scissors here to open up this plastic. I always have to be careful that I don't actually harm the actual books because that would be tragic. Alright, so the book I chose for March is The Astonishing Color of After by Emily XR Pan. And this one seemed the most interesting to me out of all the ones that I read the synopses of. They usually give you like five to choose from or so. A lot of mystery thrillers this month, and I'm not really a mystery thriller type of person. So the only other options were an adult novel and then this, which is a young adult debut novel. Emily XR Pan. Just ignore Teddy if you hear any strange noises. But this says, I didn't cry. That was not my mother. My mother is free in the sky. My mother is a bird. Lee Chen Sanders is absolutely certain about one thing. When her mother died by suicide, she turned into a bird. Lee, who is half Asian and half white, travels to Taiwan to meet her maternal grandparents for the first time. There, she is determined to find her mother, the bird. In her search, she winds up chasing after ghosts, uncovering family secrets, and forging a new relationship with her grandparents. And as she grieves, she must try to reconcile the fact that on the same day she kissed her best friend and longtime secret crush, Axel, her mother was taking her own life. Alternating between reality and magic, past and present, hope and despair, The Astonishing Color of After is a stunning and heartbreaking novel about finding oneself through family history, art, bravery, and love. So I am definitely looking forward to this. It seems like a deeper, more introspective type of read, which I love about YA novels when they delve into deeper topics. And so I'm super excited for this. Now for my extra additional book, I chose a selection that was actually presented back in February that I did not choose because I had other books that I wanted to choose. So I knew I would choose it for March. And this is An American Marriage, a novel by Tayari Jones. And this one just seemed really interesting. I was on the fence, which is why I didn't choose it in my February box. But I don't know. I keep hearing great buzz about it. Oprah raved about it. So, you know, gotta do what Oprah says. But this one, let's see. Love makes a place in your life. It makes a place for itself in your bed. Invisibly, it makes a place in your body, rerouting all your blood vessels, throbbing right alongside your heart. When it is gone, nothing is whole again. Before I met you, I was not lonely. But now, I'm so lonely, I talk to the walls and sing to the ceiling. From An American Marriage. Wow. Newlyweds, Celestial and Roy, are the embodiment of both the American dream and the New South. He's a young business executive and she's an artist on the brink of an exciting career. But as they settle into the routine of their life together, they are suddenly ripped apart by circumstances neither could have imagined when, while visiting Roy's parents in their small Louisiana town, Roy is arrested and sentenced to 12 years in prison for a crime Celestial knows he didn't commit. Though fiercely independent, Celestial finds herself unmoored, taking comfort in Andre, her childhood friend, and Roy's best man at the wedding. As Roy's time in prison passes, she is unable to hold on to the love that has been her center. When after 5 years, Roy's conviction is suddenly overturned and he returns to Atlanta, ready to resume their life together, Celestial is faced with a soul-wrenching decision, whether to let go or try to rebuild a marriage that has lost its underpinnings. Whoa. This stirring love story is an insightful look into the hearts and minds of three people who are at once bound and separated by forces beyond their control. An American Marriage is a masterpiece of storytelling, an intimate look into the souls of people who must reckon with the past while moving forward, with hope and pain into the future. Damn. T.R.E. Jones. So intense. And it's so short, which actually makes me feel better about it. Like, it seems like it's going to get to the point and it's not going to just drag on and be just filled with all this unnecessary angst and drama. So, like I said, Oprah loved it, so I had to get it. And that is it for this month's Book of the Month box. Just these two right here. I'm super excited. I will definitely let you guys know. I will be doing a winter wrap-up at the end of this month, just wrapping up all the books that I've read January, February, and March. So hopefully these two will be included. I'm just going to do the highlights, like the books I really enjoyed. So it'll probably be a pretty lengthy video. For those of you that love my lengthy videos, you'll have that to look forward to probably in the beginning of April, because I'll be filming it at the end of this month. And that's it for this video. Please thumbs up or like. Oh my gosh, thumbs up. Whoa, YouTube 2014 or 13. Please like this video, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. And I will see y'all in my next video, because I just got home from work. I'm tired. I got to go. Bye, y'all. Bye. Love you. Bye. Books to choose. Seriously. Now let's go to the big one. Ooh. Bel Canto. This was on my like books I want to read in 2018 list, so super excited, super excited. And I think I'll go with two more from the jar. Okay, Station 11 by, what's the name of this author? Emily St. John Mandel. There we go. I don't know if I own that one. I don't think I do, but did I buy it from Book Outlet? I'll have to double check. And then last, but certainly not least, let me go from the bottom of the jar. Here we go. The Bronze Horseman series. Do I want to read the entire series? I've read the first book, The Bronze Horseman, and I just recently purchased the second book. Was it the second and third? Honestly, I can never remember anything